I vividly heard officers screaming in agony.
I heard chanting from some in the crowd, get his gun and kill him with his own gun.
What we were suggested that day was like something from a medieval battle. We fought hand to hand, inch by inch, to prevent an invasion of the Capitol by a violent mob intent on subverting our democratic process. It was a prolonged and desperate struggle. The rioters attempted to breach the Capitol were shouting, "Trump, send us. Pick the right side. We want Trump." I vividly heard officers screaming in agony and pain just an arm length from me. I didn't know at that time, but that was Officer Hodges, and he's here today to testify. I too was being crushed by the rioters. I could feel myself losing oxygen and recall thinking to myself, this is how I'm going to die, defending this entrance.
I was grabbed, beaten, tased, all while being called a traitor to my country. At some point during the fighting, I was dragged from the line of officers and into the crowd. I heard someone scream, "I got one." They ripped off my badge. They grabbed and stripped me of my radio. They seized ammunition that was secured to my body. They began to beat me with their fists and with what felt like hard metal objects. At one point, I came face to face with an attacker who repeatedly lunged for me and attempted to remove my firearm. I heard chanting from some in the crowd, "Get his gun and kill him with his own gun." My body camera captured the violence of the crowd directed toward me during those very frightening moments. What makes the struggle harder and more painful is to know so many of my fellow citizens, including so many of the people I put my life at risk to defend, are downplaying or outright denying what happened. I feel like I went to hell and back to protect them and the people in this room. But too many are now telling me that hell doesn't exist, or that hell actually wasn't that bad. The indifference shown to my colleagues is disgraceful. Truly nothing has prepared me to address those elected members of our government who continue to deny the events of that day, and in doing so, betray their oath of office.